So yesterday, like I told you, the material master can be accessed by so other modules other than our SD. So the materials will be, the data relevant for those modules will be stored in respective views. Okay. Respective views are in our simple language, we could say that those are another kind of tabs. Okay. So if you may, if you start going into them at this moment, so it will be so confusing. So let us take only whatever is relevant for our sales. The relevant for sales are sales organization 1, sales organization 2, general plant data, sales text. Okay. How the general data is for customer master, where the address, contact persons, marketing data, Nielsen ID, those kind of data, payment terms, and bank details, how these kind of data were made available for all modules in the general data of the customer. Here we are having the basic data of middle master that can be accessed by all modules who use the material master. Okay. So that is why for basic data 1 and 2, you don't need any organizational unit to see those views. Okay. So let us select these sales related views and I press enter. The system will ask me for the respective units. Since I have selected the general plant, the system is asking me the plant data. Since I had chosen the sales data, it is asking me the sales organization as well as the distribution channel. So first is the basic data 1 tab. The basic data 1 tab, first is the basic unit of measure. Basic unit of measure is the lowest unit of measure which the article is being handled. For example, for this article we are handling it in pieces. If you want, if you are handling in more than one unit of measure, you can specify them in the additional data. Go to additional data, units of measure, you can say how many pieces equal to one box. Let me say 12 pieces equal to 12 PC equal to, it has to be here we will define the extra units of measure. Okay, we will come to this later. I have to find out why it happens. Okay. Then we'll be, then this material group is the material group to which this article belongs to. For example, this material belongs to the material group 00208, which is the hard disk. Where is 208? 208, it is the hard disk. Then it's your old material number. Of course, before we migrate into SAP, the business would have been up and running. So they will be having their own material number in their legacy system. Legacy system is like whichever is non-SAP, we use them in the terms of in a very broad term called as legacy system. So it doesn't mean like legacy is not sponsor system or non-ERP system, nothing like that. Whichever is other than SAP, we term it as a legacy system. So this number would have been maintained in the legacy system. Since the end users will be more comfortable with the legacy system which they have been using for a long time, so they will be remembering the old article number more frequently. So you can, if you enter the old article number here, you can use this for your search purposes. Then is the division. Division is the to which product group this article belongs to. Then we have the product hierarchy. In the product hierarchy we saw yesterday, like how this article is positioned in a hierarchy of articles. Here we had seen that it belongs to PC 00125 is the 00125 is the hardware, and the next level is 00100 is the PC, And next one is the something that comes is 1.3 is the drive. So this article is positioned in the hierarchy of hardware, PC, drive, and below this particular node 00125, this article is positioned there. This hierarchy is very useful. It's normally defined by the materials management system, and it is very useful when you are offering the discount. For example, if I announce a discount for all hardware items, then whatever article that comes under those hierarchy will get that benefit. Hence, if I say like whatever is, if I am announcing a discount for hard disk, or what is the third one? It was in PC. If you announce any discount for PC, then this product will be entitled for discount. And not only this, whichever is coming under the PC hierarchy, that will be entitled for a discount. So this hierarchy is very useful in maintaining the condition data, which means like you need not maintain discounts for individual articles. If you just tell at this node level or hierarchy node level, the system will automatically propose the discounts or prices for those articles. For all the articles, material management create this hierarchy. Then it's our general item category group. General item category group is used by the purchasing people, whereas normal just item category is used by us. We can get the item category in the sales organization 2 view. Then is our gross rate. What is the rate of this article? If you are maintaining, if you are using the volume, if you are using the transportation system, then you will be definitely needing the rate and volume of the article so that you can plan the vehicle for transportation accordingly. So in such cases, you have to enter this. Let me say this article takes up 1 cubic meter of volume. Okay. Then basic data 2. In basic data 2, we have the further advanced details like whether it is a dangerous good. If it is a dangerous good, we have to indicate the dangerous indicator profile, then how it has to be packed, those kind of details will be there. And if it is any machinery item or engineering product, then you will be having the drawing of that, else to which set of drawing it belongs to. So those kind of things are there. Okay. Then you have something called as variant configuration. Variant configuration is a part of PLM, product life management, life cycle management. In that you will find, for example, if there are so many items. Let me take example of a car. Okay. There is a car, but it will be having so many variants. What are the types of variants you can propose? One is the color, one is the upholstery, and one is the music system, and one is your air condition or so these are, let me say, as of now we have 4 variants. A customer may want a black color car with leather upholstery, a DVD player, and a very good AC system. Okay. Whereas some other customer might want a black car. They are having some budget concerns, so they will be going for your normal upholstery, and they will be going for a budget DVD player, and they might not need an AC. Okay. So each customer will be having their own requirements, and which will be configured by using the variant configuration. If this article is a configurable article, then it should be marked as the article is configurable and enter the variant configuration. Variant configuration is normally done by the PLM people, so let us not bother about this. Then we PLM, product life cycle management. That is a separate course for that. Okay. So then we come to the sales organization data. Sales organization data is our domain, our terrain. And so in here we see that we are talking about the base unit of measure, and at the same time we are talking about the sales unit. So if you are using a different sales unit, for example, we are handling this in pieces. If you want, like, no, I will be buying or handling in pieces, but when I sell, I will sell only in cartons. If that is the case, you have to maintain the sales unit here. Then it is having the delivering plant. Delivering plant says from which plant this article can be delivered from. What are the other places we had seen the delivering plant? We entered the delivering plant in some other master data also. Yeah, in customer master sales area data we entered that. Okay. So whenever we are creating a sales order, the system will first check in the something called as customer material info record for the delivering plant. Then it will check in the customer master, and if it's not found in both those places, then it will come and take the delivering plant from the material master. Yeah, Preeti? Yeah? Yeah. Okay. 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 T-S62A02. Okay. Now the thing is, like, somebody might have extended it to other countries. Okay. This whatever is marked important, this was not there earlier. Now somebody has made it as important in the account group. So that is the problem. It means, like, you have to just fill it up with some value. See here also they are entering number. So your problem was with the sales area data and the tax classification. Yeah, this is what you might have been stuck with. Yeah, this is where you might have got stuck. Okay. Do one thing. Press F4 and you enter any values from these things. Okay. So let me put it as 1. Next one is 2. 3. For Britain, I am putting 1. India, 1. United States, 1. Okay, now it must be payable. I just entered 1, 2, 3 for Canada. For the remaining rest, I entered only 1. Okay. The thing is, like, they must have entered, extended the customer to other countries also. Some other trainer, they must have done that. So it is asking for, like, sometimes we have to put up with these things because the same system is being shared by so many trainers. Let's say I had asked them for another system which is not much used. Of course, I cannot ask for exclusive system, but I asked them for any new server which is not used much. Then they gave a server ID. Just now, at the start of the class, I logged into that ID, but certain articles are not there. So tomorrow I will find out what are all the articles there, and I will speak to them so that we all get the access in the same server. Okay. So this delivering plant is what is being proposed in the sales order. if it is not found in the customer material info record and customer master. Then we come to the sales organization 2 data. In the sales 2 data, we mark the article as relevant for statistics, which means what whenever this article is being sold or it is being returned or it is taken for some other stock, it will be updating the information structure. So you are marking this article as a relevant for statistics. Then is the pricing group. This metal pricing group is also very, very much helpful in maintaining the prices. For example, I can say for all the standard parts, I am going to give some discounts. Or for all the, so this material pricing group is the group of articles grouped together in the perspective of pricing, basically. So tomorrow you can say, like, if the government says for all the spare parts, we are going to increase the tax, or if you say, like, as a business policy, like, I am going to announce an extra discount for all the standard spare parts or something. So you can use this functionality to carry out those pricing activities. Then is the volume rebate group. Volume rebate group, you can see it in more in detail when we come to the rebate, but as of now let me tell the definition. Can anybody tell what is the difference between a rebate and the discount? After the purchase. Exactly. Even the rebate is a form of a discount, it is something that is fulfilled after, I mean, like, that is given after your requirement is fulfilled. For example, I will say, like, if somebody buys $100 worth of goods, then I will give $5 as rebate, which means the sale has to be completed. The sale of $100 has to be completed. After that, the settling is done in a separate transaction. Whereas discount is that in the sales order itself, the discount will be provided, and it is almost instantaneous. Whereas the rebate is carried out in the separate process. So when we are giving a rebate for, let me say, articles. So let me say some articles. I have article A, article B, and article C. I am announcing a rebate that if anybody buys more than 100 pieces of this article A or article B or article C, or even article A and B and C, both are and. Okay. So if anybody buys more than 100, then I will be giving the discount of 2%. Okay. In case of individual purchase, tracking the crossing of that 100 limit is easy because it is a single article. You can take it from the old sales order. Whereas when it has more than one article, the system must take the count of these three articles together, the cumulative value, and then it must give the rebate. How to do that? That is normally done by the rebate group. For those three articles, enter a common rebate group. So let me say it is a 01 or 02, or I can define anything here. Okay. I can define a rebate group and assign to those three articles. So whenever I create a new rebate, the system will take, based on this volume rebate group assigned, the system will comment, okay, this is also rebate group 01 article. B is also a 01 article and C is also a 01 article. So, okay, let me combine all these articles that belong to same group and then track the cumulative value and then pass off the rebate benefit. So, that is the purpose of defining, yeah. That is in customizing. Once we come to rebate customizing, we will see that. Okay. Then is the pricing reference material. In SAP IS retail, there is a concept of variance. For example, let me say shirt. the shirt, the sizes are the same, the fabric is the same, the cuts are the same, designs are the same, everything, but only difference is the color. Let me say, for the size of size 38 or 40, I am having a white color, a teal color, a black color shirt, okay. So, the variants are only due to the color, but there is no difference in price, okay. So, tomorrow when I want to maintain price, instead of maintaining the price for these three articles, I will say, I will define the price for only one article, that is the white color shirt, and define that white color shirt as a pricing reference material for my teal color shirt and black color shirt. So whenever somebody wants to price a bill for the black color shirt, the system will take the price of white color shirt. So that is the pricing reference material assignment. Understand the example? Okay. Then we have the material groups and product attributes. Material groups, we had already assigned this material under the material group 208, that is the hard disk. Sometimes like you might want to maintain the material in more than one group. For example, you might want to maintain it on this of material group, that is the hard disk. Sometimes you want to, other than that, you might want to maintain in terms of brand. Let me say, when we are talking about hard disk, I'll say like it is a Western Digital or it is a Seagate. Else I might want, at the same time, I might want to group it under the basis of storage. So this is the more than 500 GB storage, and this is more than 1 terabyte storage. And sometimes you can use it like based on your USB connectivity. I could say like this is USB 2 connectable, this is USB 3 connectable. When you want to group an article on more than one, when you want to maintain the grouping of article on more than one, which is defined in the material group, the basic data, you can use it here. Okay. This also you can define it at the back end. So here I could say like, for one, is there anything else here mentioned? Okay, let me think that, and this is my brand, and this is my storage, so MM0. So you can maintain the different kind of storages here. I mean, for different kind of groupings, additional groupings basically. Okay. Then, so the product attributes is also very much similar. For this product attribute is useful when the customer says like, I don't want the article with certain value. For example, I could say the product attribute 1 is my black color, and the attribute 2 is the some vinyl packing or something. The customer says like, I want an article with a vinyl packing but not in black color. It means you enable the attribute here and you enable the same attribute with the customer master also. When both the attributes matches, attributes at the customer master as well as the material master matches, then the system will throw an error. So let us see it in example. I am saying that this article is having some attribute. Okay. I go to the customer master. In the sales, I am marking this. Okay. Product attribute 1. So both the keys must match. That is the only criteria. So I am saving this. So I am creating a sales order. Product attributes. So what is your article now? AP101. So let me save this. P-AP101. Okay, my order quantity is 1 piece. So it is not activated in the, actually this checking must be activated at the document level. So class and VA01 or entering the customer number. So it is saying ship to party rejects the product attribute 1 for P-8101. This is because I had enabled in my customer must, I am saying I don't want any article with product attribute 1. Okay. Whereas in the product master or material master, I had maintained that this article is having attribute 1. So the system checked from the customer master and it said like the customer doesn't want any product which is having the attribute 1, so it got rejected. Okay, is it clear? Repeat. I mean, okay, let me just repeat it again for Preeti. I told in the product attribute, my product is having a new attribute, attribute 1. Okay, this could be of anything. With the help of your adapter, you can change the description of this product attribute to whatever in real time. Let's say like the product attribute 1 is the pink color. Okay, my customer doesn't like the pink color. Okay, he says like, yeah. So he's saying like, I don't want a shirt that is pink in color. Okay, but unfortunately this AT101 is here. Pink color shirt. Okay. So when I am trying to raise a sales order for that customer with this pink color shirt, the system says the customer rejected the pink color. Let me say instead of product attribute 1, let us say pink color. The customer rejects pink color. Okay. So that is why we are not able to make a sales order for this. Okay. So let's go to next term. Ours is the plant related. In the plant related also we are seeing the same one. One is the gross weight or net weight. Here you can see an important field called as availability check. Okay. So when you are writing a sales order, at what level the system carries out an availability? I mean like think out of SAP. And when I am saying like I am today I am writing a sales order for 1000 pieces. Where will I check for those 1000 pieces? In the plant. Yeah. So that is why the availability check is placed at the plant data. And the availability check, there are many. Let us see. I mean, for us, relevant for us is 1 and 2. One is the daily requirements, which means the requirements are consolidated on daily basis and then sent to the respective department. For example, if this article, my article is not available, Okay. I mean, there is no sufficient stock. But I have to inform the appropriate department that my material is in shortage. Okay. It could be of anything. It could be either the procurement division or production division. If you inform them, either they will produce it or they will buy from somewhere. How this intimation to be done? It could be done on daily basis. It means from morning to evening, I consolidate all the requirements. Okay, at the end of the day, I am saying like today I have received a order. I mean, I have received the order for 2,200 pieces of article A. I will tell the purchasing department that today I received the requirement for 2,200 pieces. Kindly arrange to procure it. Else, I will send the requirement to production department saying like today I received a requirement of 1,000 pieces. So kindly arrange to produce them in house. So you are consolidating the requirements on daily basis and sending them to the appropriate division. There is something called as individual requirements. That is 02. Individual requirements. The moment you save the sales order, it will send the requirement to the appropriate department. The moment I save the sales order, it will say like, now I received a requirement of 100 pieces. So please arrange to procure it. Now I received a requirement of 15 pieces. Please arrange to produce that. That is it. When I create another sales order number 2, the system will tell to the procurement division, now I have received a requirement of 500 pieces. Please arrange to procure that. Hence, it will say, now I received a requirement of 100 pieces. Please arrange to produce that in-house. So, how this requirement has to be transferred to the appropriate department, that is done by the daily requirements. Okay. Then you have the batch management. If you want the articles to be handled in batches, you have to enable this. But there is a catch in that. The batch management has to be enabled the moment you create the material master. Which means, once you had created a material master without batch management, and you had even taken a goods receipt from your vendor, and after that you realize, oh, this should be a batch managed article, then if you want to go back and change that, the system won't allow you to change it to a batch management. Which means the moment you create the article, before the first goods receipt, it must be maintained as batch managed or similarly for the serial profile also. If you want the article to be maintained with the serial, maintained with some serial number, you must assign a serial profile. By default, the system takes the serial profile 001. Okay. If you want to assign the serial profile, this has to be done before any goods issue or goods receipt has taken place. Okay. So then is our transportation group. How this material is being? Hello? Yeah. Yeah? Okay. Yeah. No, you cannot. Before the first transaction, it has to be maintained. That is the, before the first goods receipt, it has to be maintained. Then you have to mark this article for deletion and you have to create another article. That is the only way. No, especially in case of your food or your medicine products or your raw materials, you always handle in batches to find out if tomorrow if there is some deficiency or quality complaints, yeah. So you will be able to track that from which batch it came, like that. Then we have the transportation group, how it is being transported, whether in pallets or cartons, something. The loading group is like how this material is loaded or stuffed into the vehicle, whether it can be done by manually or through some forklift or cranes. Okay, so that is the loading group. And finally is the sales text. If you want to enter any instructions or like fragile goods handle with care or keep this side up, so this kind of instructions which you normally use to prepare the labels. Okay, so that is maintained in the sales text. These are all the relevant views. I mean sales SD relevant views for a material master. So out of four masters, we had seen two. One is the customer master and another one is the material master. Then there is something called as customer material info record, which means, for example, the scenario is like my article number is T-AT-101, but my customer is saying like I am using the term hard disk 1TB for this. If you are sending this material with your description and your material number, my people are having difficulties in handling that while taking the goods receipt, or while so we are having some problem. So can you please maintain your description and material numbers similar to us? If he is a only customer, then you can go further. But you will be having hundreds of customers, and maintaining the data based for individual customers is different. I mean, it is a difficult one. Okay, hello. Yeah. So maintaining the values for individual customers is difficult. So what we normally do, we create something called as customer material info record. It says like for this customer, for this material, I am maintaining so and so description. So that when you are writing a sales order for that customer, the system will give the description and material number requested by the customer. The path goes like that, logistics. What happened? Sales and distribution, master data, conditions, agreement. Customer material information record is the create. Here I enter the customer, I enter the article number, my customer number is SBV2011, let me say, okay. And this is my description, and I select that, I go to details screen and maintain my customer description. Here I maintain from which stand this goods needs to be delivered from. What is my delivering quantity? Minimum delivering quantity is 5 pieces. Okay. So I maintain this value. These are extensively exclusively required by the customer. So I save this. So now I create a sales order for this customer. /NVA01. For this customer, CMIR, instead of my middle number, okay, I think they had changed the decimal, so standard setting or basic setting is. Customer material number is, let me make it as visible. So I can find the customer material number, it is SBV2011. Oh, the customer is rejecting that material. /NMM02. Okay, I maintained it in the sales organization 2. No, we don't need to remember those numbers because that is end user's work. Why you want to? Since I am using these materials regularly for my training purposes, I remember. Other than that, you need not remember these things. They do, because that is their only daily job. Okay. So I am saying HDD 2011. I am not entering my number, okay? And HDD number is, let me say, 4 pieces. Because it takes the customer's description, not our description. Can you see that? In the description, it is taking the customer's description. I enter the customer's material number. So in the sales order, you can find both the customer's material number as well as the description required by the customer, so that it will be easy for them to recognize when they take the goods receipt from their side. Okay. In fact, CMIR is the highest level or most prioritized level source of information. The system looks for information from CMIR first, like your customer material information record. Yeah, the system first looks in CMIR for your delivering plant or your delivering agreement. For example, for other articles you might want to allow partial deliveries. For this article you might not want to allow partial deliveries. So at the CMIR level you say, like, for this I want the complete agreement, complete delivery. Okay. So the system first looks for these details, like plant, your delivery agreements, whether it has to be partially or complete, and what is the minimum delivery quantity. It looks for all these details in CMIR first, and if it is not found in CMIR, then it moves to other data like customer master as well as material master. Okay. So, hello? Yeah. So, the customer CMIR is the most important one. So, however, it is not mandatory. If you are not maintaining the CMIR, that is also not a problem. But if it exists, that is the most important source of data. Okay. Then we will come to, not any slash NVD 52. This is what my CMIR is. Okay. So let me press execute. So these are the data I can handle in the CMIR. For example, what is the customer's number, middle code, what is the customer's description, what is the plant, okay, what is the delivery priority. For this article alone, I can make the delivery priority as immediate or urgent. Okay. And what should be the delivery quantity, tolerance, and your partial delivery thing. That is something called as usage that we will see when we come to the item category determination. So these are the data you can handle in the CMIR. Okay. Then we have the condition records. All our prices, discounts, taxes, free goods, material determination, even your output like your printouts, whether it has to be faxed or emailed, everything comes under the condition records. So now when we are trying to create a sales order, now the system gave the message like mandatory condition TR00 missing. Did you notice that? First, I'll create a new sales order. See here, condition records. Okay. I'm entering the article. Order quantity is 1. It says mandatory condition TR00 is missing, which means the price is not there. Okay. So when we create a sales order, what we enter? We enter the customer number, material number and the material quantity, that's it. Okay, everything is taken from the other values. Customer master, material master, and prices are not maintained at the master level, because The prices may differ based on quantity, differ based on the customer, differ based on some other parameters. Okay, that is why the prices are not tied together at the level of pricing. In the, if you go inside the master data, material master data, you can see the moving average price and other things. Okay, which you can enter. However, the prices are not taken from the material master. It is taken from something called as condition records. My price is having a condition record TR00. Okay. So to see the conditions, I can select the item and click the coin icon. So item conditions. Okay. If I go inside the here, I can see my it said my mandatory condition TR00 was missing. So TR00 is my price, and based on my cost was 309. So I cannot sell less than that. So let me put it as 395. Can you say there are many conditions? One is the price, one is your tax, one is your cash discount. Okay. If you have anything, if I click the analysis, I can still see, I mean, I can see what are still more for my customer. For example, I have the price. Okay. This is what I entered now. Okay. I have the customer discount, material pricing group discount, then gross discount or percentage discount from the gross value, then weight discount. I have so many discounts defined in my pricing procedure. But for whichever I have the value, the system will take those things only. Okay. So even though there are so many, when you came into the pricing procedure, you had only 1, 2, 3. Okay. Because we had maintained the condition records for these only. So condition green light means it is fine, working fine. If there is no value, then it will show just red. Okay. If it is not in green, it means there is some problem. Okay, let me just check. It is in red because the value is not there. Condition is, condition record is, I mean, condition is there, but value is not there. So I am replacing it with 395. Okay, now it is fine. Okay, so this is the condition record. We normally maintain the condition in a separate transaction. I go to master data, you can see the conditions inside the master data. Conditions, create, VK31. In this VK31, I can maintain the values. For example, let me maintain for prices. I go to the material price. What is the article we are having problem? T-80101. Okay. So I am going to We will see this price creation at a later time. Anyway, this I am just showing here. So what is our pricing thing? T-AT101. My, let me place the, put the amount of 395 euros per piece. This is valid from today up to 31/12/1999. That is the almost eternity. Okay. So now if I create a sales order, VA01, OR, if I enter this article, T-8101, not description, order quantity is 1, the system automatically takes the value of 395 euros. Can you see that? This is because we had maintained the condition records. If your condition records are not there, then you will be having problem in your sales order creation. So that's why you have to maintain the condition records properly, because your condition record is there, another source of master data. Clear? Yeah, yeah. You will get the price from your business. So they will be saying like, you have to, I mean like, at the time of defining the price components, you will be saying them that, you will be saying that I am going to define these components for price. So you maintain those accordingly. So based on that, they will say, okay, my price is so and so, my discount for that is so and so, my tax is this. So they will be maintaining everything. They will be telling everything and giving it in Excel sheet. You have to upload them. Okay. Okay. So did you see that in the sales order level you are able to change the value? If you want that it has to be changed at the for order basis, then you can change at the order itself. Okay, instead of 396, let me say put it as 400. Okay. Either I can do it this way or I can limit my conditions with some validity. For example, for this price I am giving, what is the validity I gave? I gave from today up to 31/12/9999. If you feel like that my price will be revised every week or every month, then you give the 1 month validity. That's enough. Yeah. It means up to 1 month that price will be there. TR00. Okay. So material with release status. Okay, fine. Okay, this instead of 23 to this one, let me say my price is still 25/01/2008. That means only for 3 days this price will be. Then in another screen, I cannot process the next interval in the same screen. Then I close this. Then I create a condition. Okay. So I will say like T-AT101. 410 euros from 26/01/2008 up to 31/01/2008. You can maintain this value this way also. Okay. So when I make a sales order on 27th, the value will be 410. If I make before 25, it will be 395. Okay, you want something so? Yeah. If you mess up in master data, your whole sales order will be in mess. You might be missing out something. Okay. So like just now, like you are entering the price manually. Just now, I mean like we entered the price manually in two, three sales orders, no? Sometimes back. Okay. It will be the similar scenario. You won't be able to process smoothly. Okay. And another thing is like, the product will be much affected. If it is missing, then you have to fill it and then save it. Okay. So that will ask for your extra time for manual processing. Okay. So on a normal day, you can make 100 sales orders if your master data are perfectly maintained. If they are not perfectly maintained, then you will end up making 50 to 60. Obviously, your productivity is affected. There is nothing like testing master data. There is no process like testing master data. But the only thing is like, when you create a sales order, if you go inside the sales order and you find that all the fields that you require for your business are populated, then I could say that your master data is fine. Still, I can have another check for that. It means like, what are all the fields I feel it is important for my business? And I will make them as mandatory in the sales order. Which means without filling them, I won't be able to save the sales order. This we will see in the incompletion log. Okay. So this is how we can normally maintain the and balance the master data. Okay. Go through the customer, I mean, we have seen all the master data by now. Okay, so go through all the master data, and tomorrow you will see the sales order processing. You will create the sales order, delivery, carry out up to billing. Okay, you will see all these steps in detail tomorrow. Okay, practice, have a good day, and we will catch up tomorrow. Bye. Bye, Preeti.